Hello and welcome back to my channel where I talk all things Squarespace and website marketing. And there is a new Squarespace store integration available and I am here to tell you all about it. If you are looking to set up a drop shipping merch store online, look no further because Printify is here and it is ready for you to connect to your Squarespace website. So in this video, we're going to run through a lot of things. First, we're going to talk about what you need to get started to make this integration happen. I'm going to share some benefits of using Squarespace e-commerce, tell you what I like about Printify, and then I'm going to create three different Printify products and ultimately a Printify store, and then show you how to integrate this new Printify store with your Squarespace website, and then talk about next steps to get you up and running and selling merch on your Squarespace website. So we have a lot to talk about. Let's just dive in. So this site right here is my full live Designing the Row website, but I have a mock website over here with nothing on it, as you can see, and I am going to use this to get started. So I'm going to show you how to start from literally zero on your Squarespace website and over here on Printify to get started. All I've done is create my login and my account and name my store Designing the Row. And I have also put in some like backend information like my name and address. Other than that, I'm going to show you how to start from zero. So that takes care of our first bullet point here. The second thing I want to talk about is the benefits of using Squarespace for your store for e-commerce online. There's a lot of reasons. The main ones that I like, especially as a designer, I love that when you build your website on Squarespace and then you add a store, it is automatically already on brand. That's probably my favorite. The other reasons are that the pricing, e-commerce is included in your Squarespace, so you might as well use it, right? There's not an extra charge to add a store to your website. So if you have a Squarespace website and you are looking to sell merch, there's no reason to go outside and find Etsy or Shopify or Zazzle or whatever other platform. Just use the integration with Printify and set up your merch store for no extra cost. And I'll give you one more benefit here. Another reason I like it is because when you have your store and your website with Squarespace, when you log into your website, not only can you see the analytics for your website, but you can check out the analytics for your store as well. And you can see your orders, all of your commerce stats, everything in one place, one login. So yes, we might be setting up a Printify account, but once you get that going, it's really kind of a set it and forget it thing, and you manage everything from your Squarespace website, which I love. First things first, we need to set up a store on our Squarespace website. So to do that, I'm going to come to the not linked section. I like to start pages that I am not ready to put in my main navigation in the not linked section. So I'm going to click the plus button and select store. And you can see it gives me option for store one or store two. Really the only difference here is that this store one starts you off with some header and some text, and this one is just products. I'm going to go with store two today and just name it store instead of store two. But the thing about that is I'm going to show you really quick. Can you see in this browser tab up here, it still says store two, which drives me nuts. But if you click on this little settings icon here and you come to SEO, all you have to do is backspace on that SEO title here and save. And it will change to say just store. Now I'm going to move my face and let's select all of these products and delete. We don't need any of those. It always gives me an error code, which is a lot of fun, but they'll delete in a minute. Usually. So we will just leave that there. So we've got our store started on Squarespace. Now we are going to move over to Printify. First, I want to say thank you to Printify for sponsoring this video. A few things I like about Printify since I gave you my spiel on Squarespace. Printify is super easy to use, similar to Squarespace. There are over 500 products in their catalog that you can choose from. Honestly, the hardest part about this for me was going through the catalog and picking which products I wanted to showcase today and what I actually wanted to create for this video. So over 500 products, you can get started for free. There is a Printify premium option, but that's for if you expect higher volume of sales, you can get a lower price on the actual merch itself. But today I'm going to be showing you just my free account here on Printify. The other thing I really like about Printify and just dropshipping in general is that there is no inventory that you have to deal with as the store owner. So dropshipping works because you create your products here. When somebody orders it on your website, Printify will just make however many or whatever that person ordered and send it directly to them. So there is no inventory and you do not have to do any manual shipping, which is amazing. So it's kind of like you create your store and your products, you set it up on your website, and then you just make money. You don't have to do anything else to get the products out to your customers. Okay, and now let's talk about Printify product and store creation. I told you I had already started my Designing the Rose store. Now we are going to create products. So I have picked out a couple products that I'm going to show you how to create. And to do that, I'm going to come to the catalog. And I have decided to do some journals and a water bottle because those are two things I personally can't live without every day. So I'm going to customize some and make them my own. So let's start with the journals over here, the far right. I'll show you how I actually ended up narrowing down which journal I actually wanted to use. So you can see over here, there's fulfillment location filter. I'm going to switch on United States. And I personally like a notebook that has a spiral bound. It's easier for me to use. So there's this one up here at the top, and then there's this one down at the bottom as well. So I'm going to do just one of each. So we can start with this one up here at the top. This one is, it allows you to customize the front cover, but the back cover is just solid black. To get started designing it, all you have to do is hit this green start designing button. And you can see the print area size listed right here for you. So what I did was just use Canva and I created my graphics for these products in Canva. I just set custom dimensions. So I am going to hit add your design because I already have mine ready. I'm going to say my device, open this file. And there is my design. It fits perfectly since I already have the exact dimensions. But you can see that my Designing the Row text right here kind of hits right on that border. So I'm just going to click and drag and move my design over a little bit. And this works for me because that edge, that right edge of my design is just solid white. So just keep that in mind when you are designing that you'll need a little bit of margins. I'm going to hit save on this. And there you can see listed in my products is my new notebook. So I am going to click into the spiral notebook here. And you can see we've already got mockups. We've got a description area, variants, and store details. So let's come back up to the top. You can see if I click on this, there's already a mock-up of what the journal or little notebook would look like. And it gives you several different options. So here it is with the notebook opened. Super helpful. You don't have to create any mock-ups for your store on your own. They do it for you. So I am going to come edit this title and description a little bit. I'm going to say geometric, let's call it the DTR geometric notebook. And I'm just going to delete some of this. And keep in mind, you can edit the title and description and all that in Squarespace too. So none of this has to be final. I'm just going to quickly make a couple changes. Okay, so we've got our mockups, our title and description, and now comes in one size, so we'll sell the one size. You can see it gives the cost. So $7.69 is what I would owe Printify if somebody were to order this. The retail price is what I will charge on my website, and then the profit is the difference. So that I would make $513 if somebody bought this notebook on my website. If you would like to adjust these numbers, just hit this little down arrow here. And you can either change the retail price, the profit, or the profit margin. I'm just going to change this to an even $15. And you can see it changed my profit to $731. So we've got our price set. Now down here, you can see it won't let me publish yet. And that's because I haven't connected my Printify account to Squarespace yet. So I'm just going to save this product for now as a draft. Okay, so we've got one product ready to go. Now let's make my other journal. So with this journal, it's a little bit different because the front and back are both printed. So again, start designing. I'm going to add my design from my device. And there we go, it fits perfectly. So I'm going to save product and we'll click in here again. And you can see this time we have some more mockups since the front and the back of the product have been customized. So you can scroll through these and see all of these. When you connect your Squarespace store to Printify, it will actually upload all of these images for you already too. And again, we'll save as a draft. Okay, so now I've got our two different notebooks here. If you want to edit the positioning of your design after the fact, this little paintbrush icon here, you can edit your design. Let's do one more product. I'm going to come to catalog and bottles and tumblers. Again, just like I did for the notebooks, I'm going to narrow it down to United States. And I have picked these right here because I personally love a water bottle that has a straw. As you can see here, I've got the one on my desk. So I picked one that was just like this, and I'm going to start designing. Again, here's your print area size. Grab these pixels, put them in Photoshop, put them in Canva, wherever you want to design. Add your design, my device, my file, and it's just gonna have my logo on it. And let's reposition it a little bit. See how this works. Save product. Okay, so now that we have three different products, we can create an actual store. And now let's link it and integrate Printify with Squarespace. So to do that, I'm going to do that through Printify. So if I hover over designing the row up here, I'm going to click manage my stores, and then I'm going to hit connect. And you can see it gives me multiple options here. Squarespace here, I'm going to hit connect. And you can see up here it's thinking, it's redirecting me to Squarespace, so just give it a second. And I have done a lot of websites, so let's see how quickly it can find mine. So I'm going to select my site. I'm going to click allow to install Printify on Squarespace. Let's connect my store, designing the row, and click continue. And here it says success. I'm going to X out of that. Okay, so now, remember our products are still saved as drafts, so we need to publish our products so that they actually can be live in the store. So I'm going to click into my water bottle, and now you can see the publish button has turned green for me, so I'm going to click that, and then we can go into the notebooks and do the same here. Publish, and one more, publish. You can see the water bottle is published and the other two are publishing. Let's go to our Squarespace store. Let's just see what happens if I refresh here. And there we go. We've got all three there. Let's try to delete these products again. There we go. And now I have my Printify products created and loaded on my Squarespace store. You can see even when I hover over these products here. The alternate images are already set up to display. If I click into, let's say, this teal notebook here, you can see all of the mockups here are already loaded for me. Click through and see all of those. We've got the title, the price, the description, and your store is ready to go. So if you do want to edit any of these products once they have been added to your Squarespace, just hover over this edit in the top left and hit edit product. And here you can see you can edit the title, the description. You can drag and drop and reorder these pictures, or you can delete any of them that you don't want to keep. This one looks a little repetitive to me. Let's delete that. And you don't need to set inventory because this is drop shipping. So you can see they already have it on unlimited. If you keep going down, you can add your own categories and tags. You can add your SEO description by clicking edit here. You can add a social share image if you would like to change that. And then your checkout customization is here. But for now, I'm just going to hit save. And if you haven't already set up your store before and you want to edit, say, like this add to cart button color or the layout of your product page, if you hover over that edit again and hit edit design and click the edit here, this format and colors here is how you can customize your actual product page on Squarespace itself. I'm just going to hit done for now. Okay, so we've gotten through all of this. Now, next steps. So you are not totally done yet. Just because the products are set up on your Squarespace site, you still need to do a few more things. You can see here, I've got some notifications from Squarespace to keep going, to continue setting up your store. I'm not going to do this here in this video because I have many other videos on my channel all about setting up a Squarespace store that you can follow if you need some more assistance. But if you hit this keep going button, it will walk you through setting up. Like, you need to connect your Stripe or PayPal account so you can actually collect money, set up your shipping, and get your store ready to go live. So once you do that, then you'll officially be ready to go live. And then what I'm going to do actually is come back over to Printify, and what I'm going to do is order samples of these products so I can actually physically hold and see them and see what they look like. And once I do that and approve of all my products, I'm actually going to push the store live over here on my real website rather than just my demo website so that you can shop for designing the rose swag yourself. So I'm going to go order samples. If you have any questions for me about connecting Squarespace and Printify, let me know in the comments. And again, like I said, I have lots of videos on setting up your Squarespace store. I will link that playlist here in the video for you to check out as well. So happy selling, and I will see you in the next video.